two major policy papers, methodological approach and the theories. The daughter of Wilson is a review, but again, as I said, the review is being framed by the theories that you now without dictating what you read and how you read. And basically, the theories provide logical explanations. Okay? What the review basically means. The vendors have been taken in by groups that we realize, because they can put the specialty or a couple of reports and then they read some stuff that just don't make sense, as I said yesterday. Makes sense, the patterns that exist within the literature, etc. And also it will shape and help the researchers set the theories and the parameters that we use to read what we read, that will give us direction to exactly what it is that we need. Of course, with this, you use different files. Basically, a file, I think it's a model of the global population to some extent, to see and to understand. So, basically, for simple purposes, if you take a more realistic approach of international events, or you can take a more liberal approach. And therefore, those two paradigms just support each other, and they help give a good interaction, a good interplay, and help you to interrogate what is you're trying to interrogate. Because, of course, you don't think on one side. Okay, normally the paradigm usually does change. For those of you who would have come out of the diploma, when you're looking at things like liberalism and realism, you have the old school, the classical school, and then you have the newer open library school. Why? It takes a while. It normally takes about 20 to 30 years for updates to be made, and therefore the paradigm to shift slightly, and therefore we go into the concept of new business. As you will know from Google, and for those of you who haven't done it yet, again, with a lot of these theories, you have micro and macro theories. For anybody who's doing research, if you're proper research, you're doing research for articles and stuff, all your papers, you'll realize that there's normally a large body of evidence out there. But even within that body, there are other theories that happen. And therefore, you need to know what is micro theory that you're dealing with, as well as what is macro theory dealing with. A lot of times, people get confused, suspecting or interpreting the micro to be macro. And that leads to obvious confusion. Okay, this you don't know, you don't need, because we have basically only an hour. Alright, just as a background to how the early thoughts started. And if you're logical, the benefits are the political stage. And therefore, in the old days, a lot of the old theories had assumed that everything would go the same way. And people lived in that way for a very long time, and then we really went into that stage where God plays a little bit, a little bit of philosophy. For those of us in the history, etc., you know, with the Renaissance, etc., where we started to bring observable facts, and we started even a little more scientific inquiry. And of course, the final stage, the positive stage, science dominates thought. So, for a simple example, long ago, you assume that if you get up in the morning and you bounce your toe, and by bouncing your toe, you ran late because you had to put on a plaster, and then you realize that had you been on time, the car you would have been in got into accident, and the same words you'd be like. Well, a lot of people nowadays, you see it tomorrow, God with it, God bless, etc. It's from old superstitious days. But now you know that you weren't there on time, you didn't get in the accident because basically the time, distance, temporal thing that you just didn't work out for you to be in. Does that make sense? And that's how a lot of thought goes. I mean, even in the discipline you were before, a lot of stuff that you read before, old theory long ago, that people believed and will believe, just don't make sense to us now. Okay? Simple example, also, if you read or you read things like basic anthropology, sociology, etc., they assume that black people were the smarter white people because they had the shape different, etc., etc., etc. Or even used to this these days, people like Moscato, Pareto, etc., Italian, so generally racist in their own view anyway, believe